away from there! Now!
our new line of subterranean vaults featuring our patented Triple S technology. Triple S technology is Vault Tech's convergence of the three most important parts of apocalyptic endurance: safety, survivability, and sanitation. Withstand a direct hit by an atomic bomb with only a projected 2% failure rate. Sun lighting mimics the feeling of being outside with only a fraction of the sunburn potential. The living sections make use of our revolutionary floor sock auto cleaner system for those darned messy kids. Never sweep again! Moms will love how our Culinator 3000 kitchen system makes cooking a breeze. I can smell the muffins baking now. Or, don't be. Step into our Entertainatron room and watch the latest holotapes, or perhaps listen to a symphony. Another Vault Tech innovation. Concerns about security? Our Eye on You cameras enable the Vault Cleaner to watch your every move. You'll never be alone again! Should the unlikely event arise that the planet is laid to waste, you'll feel happy knowing your family will be safe in a Vault Tech vault. We hope you've enjoyed our tour today. If you have any further questions, please take a brochure from our helpful Vault Tech guides. Thank you.
man has had an insatiable hunger for knowledge regarding the universe. To understand why man is so interested in this unknown expanse of space around our little
now
world...
Now try and hide!
Understand why man is so interested in this unknown expanse of space around our little world. We must take a journey. Please, sit back, relax, and free yourself from the bonds of our planet as we take off for the stars.
Yeah! Carver!
Right!
Understand why man is so interested in this unknown expanse of space around our little world. We must be. Thank you.
Move along, outsider.
Dweller number two was none other than James's kid. I know, I couldn't make this shit up. Okay, but now it gets kinda sad. You see, the kid is looking for his dad. Looking for James. See, James left Vault 101 without telling the kid why. Now, I've since learned that James is a scientist and is working on something big. Is that why he left the vault? Looks that way. So who knows? Maybe James is going to save the world. Think of a better cause than that. But James, if you're listening, your kid's out, man. And he misses you. So you might want to find him before he gets swallowed up and spit out. And for all you other cats out there listening, if you see the kid from Vault 101 out there, give him a pat on the back and wish him luck. Until next time, this is Three Dog, ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth.
Hey, all right! The hero of the wasteland returns! Smoke a peace pipe, man. You know, you are so unlike your father. I suppose that's what you want to know next. When your dad passed through here, he and I talked for a good long time. He's a real stand-up kind of guy. He mentioned some scientific mumbo-jumbo, which didn't make sense to me, and mentioned something called Project Purity. He also said something about going to visit a Dr. Lee in Rivet City. Then he left in a hurry. You've never heard of Rivet City? Wow. Just wow. Well, a whole bunch of people got together and turned a beached aircraft carrier into a town. Pretty cool, huh? Just follow the river south from here. There's no way you can miss it. I can't even tell you the love I'm getting from the wasteland. Ever since G and I started singing again, the guys downstairs told me that more people than ever are tuning in.
It's all I ever wanted.
Without this place, DC would be filled with that crap the Enclave keeps shoveling out of their radio station and festering with muties. Someone's gotta tell the Wastelanders what time it is, and Three Dog is the one to do it. No one knows what Eden and his horsemen of the apocalypse are up to. But you can be sure it isn't in the common man's best interest. Three Dogs seen it all. The capital wasteland at its ugliest. People killed for scraps of food, wounded children wandering aimlessly. Some seriously fucked up shit. If it wasn't for the good fight, I think I would have gone crazy by now. You've got to understand, if I die, so does the voice of the people. I can't take that risk. Your idea of saving the world means combing through the rubble and using a gun. I use my voice. We're two sides of the same coin. If you think always being a target of your enemies is safe, then you got a funny way of looking at things. Why candy coat the news when the world is in danger? People like the Enclave would have you believe everything is calm and totally under control. They're lying. Hell, President Eden goes around spreading peace, love, and government, but no one even knows how old that Enclave signal really is. People need to hear the truth. It's a harsh world. We've got to work together to make it better, not wait for Uncle Sam to ride in and save the day. Okay. Anytime you need a place to crash, duck in here.